Hi, welcome back to my world of fragrance. We're going to be looking at another hyped up brand today, one that's kind of been in the blogger sphere. I heard about this brand from Estée Lalonde, if any of you follow her or watch her on YouTube. Hey girl, if you're watching. And I thought, why not review this brand? Initially, when I heard that this was an LA-based, cruelty-free, clean beauty type of brand, I thought, oh no. Not that I don't agree with those things, but I think it's like the perfume snob inside of me that kind of was like, okay, another one of those brands. But anyways, let's take a deeper dive into Maison Louis Marie. So this house was created by Marie du Petit Thouars in, I believe, 2015-ish. That's when their first perfume oils were released. I think that this house is mainly known for their fragrance oils. That's what everyone has kind of been talking about, the little small format of their oils. I am going to show you one, and I will reveal which one that I purchased from the line. Marie du Petit Thouars kind of markets on the fact that she's not a typical LA girl or an LA woman. She grew up in Belgium, where she, as a little girl, experimented with making scents and candle making, perfume making through botanicals. And there's a special way that her family has kind of been passing on this way of creating fragrances. So she used to experiment in her mother's greenhouse. And the original method of extraction from florals, or the way that they created these fragrances, was handed down from her ancestor, Louis-Marie Aubert du Petit Thouars. So hence the name Maison Louis-Marie. And it's said that these fragrance techniques came from 1792, so hundreds of years ago, and now this Marie decided to create her own brand. So these perfume oils are made to enchant your lifestyle, and what really drew me to these oils is the packaging. I'm going to reveal which one I bought right now, and I don't think it's going to come to any surprise if any of you know of this house or have heard of it, but it is number 4, and that is Bois de Balincourt. So all of these are numbered. I think the highest one is number 12, or the newest one is number 12. I'm not sure if they're in chronological order. She did release a whole bunch of these in 2015 altogether, and this was one of the original collection. So people have been raving about this scent, like raving. And I, of course, wanted to find out what the hype was all about. So I tried this on my skin in the boutique, and I told myself, if it's love at first sniff, I'm going to purchase it. And lo and behold, it was. Not that this is the most unique scent or, you know, uniquely crafted, revolutionary type of perfumery that's out there, but I really did enjoy the format. So this is the packaging. As you can see, the box looks like this. Name, pretty simple. As you know, they market on the clean beauty aesthetic, so there is no plastic wrapping in this. And there you have the cute little bottle. This is a 15 milliliter bottle, and this is a perfume oil format. So the way that you apply it is that you rub this directly onto your pulse points or what have you, and rub it together to warm up. So initial thought was, this smells exactly like Santal from Le Labo. And that was something that I had in the back of my mind already. I had read about this, and there were many comparisons to Santal, and I do agree, this smells pretty much spot on to Santal. So if you have Santal from Le Labo, there's no need for you to get this fragrance, unless you're looking for a smaller format, possibly, but I do think that Le Labo comes in like smaller roller balls as well, if you're interested in that. It's very much, I would say, like a hipster type of scent or a hipster vibe. Like if you go to certain circles, you're going to smell that a lot of people are trying to smell unique by wearing Santal. But all of them are wearing it, so they're not really getting anywhere. But they do smell hip and trendy and all of that. The sandalwood is very prominent. It has florals in there as well. And I would say that it smells like a prominent dry sandalwood mixed with expensive perfume. So it doesn't smell entirely natural at all. It does smell like a fragrance, but it kind of has that mix of nature meets fragrance. It is one that I find that is quite versatile. It's easy to wear. It's one that you can just always throw on. And the reason why I actually bought this was for layering. I layer everything. So having this and knowing that it's a clean product, so the ingredients don't contain any toxins, it's something that you can apply to your skin liberally without worrying about any of that stuff being absorbed. I thought that that was a huge selling point. Now, these are quite expensive. For 15 ml, these cost $57. So they are meant to last a long time, but it's not like the longevity is like super long. I do find that on clothing, I smell this the day after. So 12 plus hours later, it is very, very faint. But it is one that I would reapply for sure. And I don't find that it projects very well either. I haven't gotten any compliments on this. I've heard that people go crazy for this. Hasn't happened to me, but I don't care about what other people think anyway. But to me, this is just an easy, handy one to throw into your purse or to throw into your bag, and you can always top up. And if you're in a place where you can't exactly spray perfume, say you're traveling, etc., and you want to top up your smell, then this is a nice way of reapplying. So as I mentioned, I tried several from this line. Just because this is the most popular does not mean that it's the absolute best. I just found it to be the most versatile for me and not anything that I had in my collection because I don't own Santal and I wanted this for layering purposes, as mentioned. Antidris Cassis, that's another one that they have in their line, and this one smells exactly like L'Ombre dans l'eau from Diptyque. It's a very musky rose with black currant and pepper notes inside of it. And if you're looking for a fragrance that is on the sexy side maybe, but still versatile and leans feminine, then I would go with that one. I was debating between getting either number 4 or number 10. Number 10 is called Aboukir, and that one is more masculine. I would say it's the most masculine one of the line. That is a very dry, rooty, earthy kind of scent. Another one that's great for layering, and like I said, to me that is the most unisex, so I would probably go and get that one next just due to seasonality. And then around springtime, summertime, I would go for number 11. Number 11 is La Thémis, and this one is a very fresh green fragrance. It smells exactly like or very, very similar to Herba Fresca from Guerlain, if you know that fragrance. I love it for summertime. I love it for like that pick me up middle of the day during the hot season. And this smells very much like, if you're familiar with the End Other Stories fragrances, they used to have one called Moroccan Tea, which I absolutely loved as well. I had the body lotion, all of that. So I will be going out and getting La Thémis, I believe. Now, number 2, called Le Long Foam, that is pure patchouli to me. So if you're interested in a patchouli fragrance for layering perhaps, or to have in your purse in this format, then I would go for Le Long Foam. That's another one that I find to be quite unisex. And the last one that I tried on my skin was Candili, and this one is number 5. It's a very tuberose heavy scent. I don't gravitate towards tuberose normally, but if you're a person who loves tuberose fragrances, then go for that one. It does become very warm, very pleasant on the skin. I did find that it did project more than a few of the other ones. It turned almost cinnamony with a hint of sandalwood in there as well. So a beautiful tuberose. So all in all, these are my impressions of Maison Louis Marie. I do find them on the pricey side in terms of how much you're getting. If all of their claims about this being completely clean, etc., and not bad for you are true, then I guess maybe it's worth the investment. Like I said, I really, really enjoy the format of this. I'm just a sucker for packaging, I mean. And I will be layering this with a lot of scents this upcoming season, this fall. I do also find this an easy one to throw on when I'm just in the house and I want something pleasant. So if I apply it behind my ears, I do get wafts of it as well throughout the day. All in all, another trendy brand that has received a lot of hype. Again, I wouldn't expect like the most unique perfume mastery, but Maison Marie Louis has kind of been able to identify what kind of fragrances sell and have kind of replicated that and used their format and their packaging as a way to market it, and I feel like they've succeeded quite well. So likable, easy fragrances, go and check them out. Thank you for watching this video. As always, please leave a comment down below, give this video a like, and let me know what other requests you may have for brands out there that you find other people are talking about. You're not necessarily gonna spend your money on it, so let me do it for you and I will give you my honest review. So all of... Sorry, I just need this shirt, the t-shirt. Where's your t-shirt? Fine, I'll give you one of these. Let me see that. There's a white t-shirt in there.